SELFSEE, spoken easy language for social inclusion.
So we will continue with our panel. So we welcome up Hjalmar. No, we will start with Camilla that we have online, Camilla Boyström. She's part of our cooperation group, but she's also been doing testing. So welcome, Camilla. Can you hear us?
And I think we will switch to Swedish now.
Yeah.
Hey, Camilla.
Hey.
Ja, det blir lite krångligt, Camilla. Men hör du oss?
Hör du?
Ja, vad bra. Och då får vi göra det så här. Jag tänkte helt enkelt fråga dig, vad är det viktigaste när du lyssnar på böcker?
Vad sa du? Jag hör dem.
Vad du tyckte var det viktigaste för att det ska bli en bra inläsning?
Ja, det var inte för snabbt. Och inte för vad heter det? Ja, för att det inte blir för monoton.
Inte för monoton.
Monotont.
Med inlevelse och ganska långsamt.
Ja. Och inte mer person, inte för inte fram vad det heter. Inte för känslosamt och inte för monotont utan. Nej.
Så det fanns ett mittemellanläge där det var viss inlevelse men det skulle gå ganska långsamt.
Mm.
För vi hade ju en inspelning där det var väldigt långa mellanrum mellan varje ord. Men det är inte så du vill att det ska gå långsamt.
Nej, det är bra med lite efter i slutet av meningarna så att man får en liten paus där som kan tänka efter vad det handlar om lite grann.
Så pausen ska komma, först läser man en liten bit och så finns det ett naturligt ställe där man kan göra en paus. Och då gör man en ganska lång paus där och sen fortsätter det. Var det så som det funkade?
Nej, jag hörde inte.
Jag vet inte om du hör mig längre, Camilla.
Jo, jag hör.
Ja.
Hör ni mig eller?
Jag hör dig jättedåligt.
Ja, bra. Mm.
Det blir en annan sorts kommunikation mellan människor det här. Men det, vi testade ju 7 olika varianter. Och jag tror det var ganska tydligt vad du tyckte var viktigt för att det ska funka. Lyssnar du och läser mycket böcker?
Ja, det gör jag. Men då använder jag det på Legimus.
Så jag kan... det är de här talböckerna som vi fick presenterade. Liksom.
Ja. Ja, för då läser jag och lyssnar samtidigt. Så kan jag bestämma hastighet själv. Så. För det varierar ju.
Brukar du dra ner hastigheten då?
Det beror på vem som pratar. Ja. Som läser upp. Så. En del går ju normalt och ibland lite långsammare.
Så olika inläsare läser lite olika fort.
Mm, det gör det. Sen var det någon gång när det märkte jag mig en gång att det var en som läste. Ja, det var väldigt monotont och så den orkade jag inte lyssna på alls. Så den tog jag bort med en gång. Även om det skulle vara väldigt intressant.
Så om inte de här kvaliteterna blir uppfyllda, då kan det förstöra läsningen?
Ja, verkligen.
Tack. Jag tror vi ska... Ja, vill du vara? De undrar lite, vad är din lässvårighet, Camilla?
Ja, jag får se. Så, ja, och för mig så är det jag måste... Det är inte att jag inte hör, men det tar lite längre tid innan jag förstår vad det handlar om. Hörselförståelse eller vad det heter.
Tack, du kan hänga kvar, men jag tror jag ska bjuda fram resten av panelen. Va?
Och vi stänger ner telefonsamtalet.
De lägger på telefonen nu. Det blir för komplicerat med all teknik. Tack,
Tack,
Camilla.
Camilla. Would we have a short recap in English because I think
So we can have a short recap in English. Camilla, who is in the aphasia organization, she listened a lot to talking books from the service that was presented earlier. So she borrows a lot of books there, and the pace is the most important for her. And what she said was that different narrators, even if there are guidelines, they read in different pace. So someone is reading too fast, then she tries to because you can adjust the pace in the recordings. So sometimes she needs to do that. And sometimes the sort of default recording is okay, but sometimes it's too fast. And then she wants pauses between sentences or paragraphs. She wants a longer pauses between sentences and paragraphs, but not pauses between every word, because that was one of the versions that we was testing. And if the quality of the recording is too bad, she won't listen even if the book is really interesting. So the quality topples the interest. Ja, hej panelen.
Hej.
Hej.
Hey. Och jag tänker att vi kan väl börja lite snabbt för att berätta vilka ni är, om Ester klickar runt mikrofonen.
Det ska jag göra.
Okay, hello, my name is Charlotta, and I since I don't know what to call it in English, but burned out for several years ago, I can't concentrate on reading. And as an adult, I was diagnosed ADHD. Yes.
Jag pratar svenska. Hoppas det är okej. Jag heter Inger Olenius och jag har arbetat på Dyslexiförbundet väldigt många år. Men nu är jag pensionär och jobbar ideellt. Jag har själv dyslexi och jag älskar talböcker. Talböcker och talsynteser är det bästa som finns. Och jag tycker om, jag kommer gå in på det mer i detalj sen, men jag vill att det ska vara lite snabbt och flyt.
Vi tar det sen.
Ja, tack.
Jag heter Hjalmar. Jag är svenska. Jag är svenska. Hjalmar.
Hej, min namn är Laura. Jag har dyslexi. Jag vill bli mer motiverad att läsa talböcker. Så det är riktigt spännande att vara med. Hej, min namn är Luz. Är det bäst på engelska eller svenska?
Ta svenska du.
Ja. Jag har autism och psykiska problem som jag gör det svårt med kognitiv. Men det kom i perioden. Och jag har också väldigt känslighet för olika sensoriska uttryck som just ljud. Och jag skulle önska att jag kan använda mer talböcker. Och som jag själv så kan jag ha det inte svårt med betyg om till det.
Men du var med här, Los, och vilken... Vad var viktigast för dig när du avgjorde vilken kvalitet var viktigast för dig när du lyssnade?
För mig är det först och främst rösten.
Rösten.
Ja. Om jag inte tålar rösten så kan jag inte alls lyssna då. Jag håller med med vad du sa, eller Camilla sa, att kvaliteten trumpar intresset. Det går inte att lyssna om det är fel inställning. Det går inte. Och sen var hastighet också väldigt viktigt, men det, när vi diskuterade så den verkar med tekniken mer och mer möjligt att anpassa rösten hur den låter, så att anpassa. Och jag vill inte heller ha för mycket inlevelse. Det var någon som sa det innan, att jag vill skapa min interpretation av texten och min inlevelse. Då ska inte den andra bestämma det åt mig.
Tack, vi skickar vidare till Laura, för jag tror att du vill att det ska gå lite fortare än de andra när du lyssnar.
Ja, jag också kan ha lite fortare, för också lite så blev det rastlös var det hården. För jag varnade min far när han läste böcker när jag var liten, att det gick ändå ganska snabbt. Och sen gillade jag inlevelse och sånt, så jag fångas med, så jag inte tappar intresset. För läsa och sånt har alltid varit typ en frustration för mig. Att det har aldrig varit någon kul grej, så det är svårt att komma in i det. Det var ju roligast när far läste på en när man var liten. Man ville ju kunna ha ljudböcker själv. Men sen också att det inte ska låta... Det är väl jobbigt när det låter för mycket data. Att det är konstigt att rösten inte låter naturligt mjukt. Det kan vara också väldigt jobbigt. Eller ibland så pratar de alldeles för fort. Det var oftast jag som gillade när man var lite fortare. Och sen att de har känsla i det. Så jag fastnar i intresset. I boken.
Jag tror att det var du som sa, Laura, om det går så här sakta så kommer jag att somna.
Ja, det är säkert att man säger sömnig och håller på att somna. Som när man lyssnar på jättelugn musik. Så håller man på att somna och sen lite mer peppig musik så blir man mer så inne i det. Som jag tänker mycket på.
Men sen fanns det en annan grej också som du lyfte, och det var ju när inläsaren hade skarpa ljud, alltså S-ljud framförallt.
Skarpa ljud var hej, och sen S-et eller någonting loss. Jo, det är sådana ljud som var väldigt jobbiga för fördes öronen. Men om det hade gått det känns lärare, tycker jag var väldigt bra hörsel och hör på mitt vägar, ja.
Det var diskantljud, och det kanske är samma för dig, Los, att då blir det en, det blir någonting i inspelningen som stör väldigt mycket.
Ja, jag minns att vi reagerade på samma uttal. Det var vissa bokstäver som uttalades på ett visst sätt, så att det gjorde nästan ont.
Ja, det skärde sig.
Ja, precis. Det skärde sig. Så det har vi ju samma upplevelse.
Vi fick mikrofonen till dig, Almar. Vad tycker du är viktigt när du lyssnar?
Jag tycker att det inte ska gå inte för snabbt och inte för långsamt. Det ska liksom vara lagom på något sätt. Och samtidigt att det inte, som du sa, inte för datorgjort eller robotaktig röst vill man inte ha. Så det låter som en robot, och inte för monotont heller. Men det är det som är det viktiga liksom. Men ja, det var vad mer vi sa, men det var
för långa pauser.
Ja, det var också en onaturliga pauser på vissa ställen. Det var en som läste liksom ett ord, sen det var lång paus mellan varje ord, och då blir det liksom bara som de räknar upp ord ungefär. Det liksom måste ju vara kortare paus mellan orden, och sen så kanske lite längre när det är en ny mening, och när det är nytt stycke kanske lite ännu längre. Inte att det är lika lång paus mellan varje ord, det blir väldigt konstigt. Det låter väldigt onaturligt. Så det var de sakerna vi pratade om.
We will do a short translation in English. What's going on? So what Laura and Luz are saying is that it shouldn't be too slow. They need more of a tempo in the recording, the reading. And they want somewhat a feeling or a tone, not that neutral reading that Inge, for example, appreciates. And yeah, Luz.
Jag var som Inger.
You were some Inger. Ja. Sorry. It's Laura that more wants the sort of feeling in the recording. And if it's too slow, she says, I will fall asleep. So there is a sort of... So we are not agreeing, the group. The group doesn't agree on how to do the recordings and how much emphasis should be put in the reading. That's a different reason. But also what we are talking about is that a specific narrator could be we don't want that one. We won't listen to anything that person has read. So it's important to pick the right person doing the recording. But we not agree on that either. Who is not listenable? So people prefer different narrators. So you start to see the complicated pattern here. Hjalmar is talking about pauses between sentences, or where should if. And that was also what Camilla was mentioning. It's good that the reading is slow, but you can slow it down in different ways. You can read everything very slowly. Or you can have a pause between every word, or you can have a pause between after a sentence or a paragraph. And you could sort of elaborate a bit with how long should that pause be. And the narrator was a really interesting person, because we made him to do different kind of readings. So and we were really impressed that we said, you should read this in this way. And he did it. So we have seven different versions of the same text. And in one recording, we asked him to have long pauses between every word in that reading. So, and that becomes not listenable, because it was too long pauses between every word. So you lose contact with the story. So it seemed better to have pauses after a sentence, and perhaps an even longer pause after the paragraph. And then the reading could be quite fast, actually, because the impression becomes slow if you have pauses. So also people try to adjust the pace in the recording, and that sometimes that works, but sometimes the quality of the text become too poor when you make it too slow. Some people actually also increase the pace, and that technically wise that functions better to speed up than to speed down. That was the panels so far, and now we switch back to Swedish. Yeah. Yeah. Then Laura said, there was sort of trebling sounds in the recording, especially when people are saying some S sounds that really, really was disturbing. So that was a quality in the recording that wasn't good. So trebling sounds could be very, very troublesome for some. Okay, tillbaka till svenska. Och vad tyckte du? Inger, du är ju fanatisk läsare, lyssnare, läsare, läsare.
Ja, jag läser väldigt många talböcker och har gjort det i 30-tal år. Så att och ju mera talböcker jag läser, ju mer accepterande blir jag. I början så var jag ju så att det fick inte vara för långsamt och inte för snabbt. Och jag tyckte absolut inte om talsyntes. Alltså robotröst. Men nu när jag har läst så många olika röster och även olika talsynteser, så har jag blivit vän med talsynteserna. Men så jag lyssnar på en hel del böcker med talsyntes. Men jag föredrar böcker med mänsklig inläsning. Och jag tycker det är viktigt att det är ett visst tempo, att det rullar på. Det får inte vara för långsamt, för då tappar man intresset. Och det är väldigt svårt att beskriva. Men det bästa är när man inte irriterar sig på någonting. Man bara lyssnar eller man bara läser och tycker att det är superhärligt innehåll. Och man försvinner bort in i texten. Men om man irriterar sig på någonting, då går ju texten delvis förlorad. Tack.
Så So what Inger is saying is that if you start to be disturbed of something in the recording and start to pay attention to that, the sort of the story gets in, because you divide your attention to parts of the quality in the recording and not being sort of immersed in the story. And the best recordings is when you don't think about that, you just listen to the story. Vad var viktigast för dig?
The pace. I don't want it to be too slow. I was very impressed by the narrative when he sounded like almost like staccato, like a robot. And I hate when I can hear the narrator inhale. You know, it's so annoying. And I prefer mostly when the author themselves read the books, because I don't know, I prefer often, and I choosing which narrator who has narrated the book.
Yeah. So you look at who is the narrator, and then you pick the book.
Yes. Okay. Oh, mostly, or the genre. Yeah. It depends, yeah. But I prefer when the author himself or narrating the books.
Yeah. So you have a top 10 list of authors if you like.
Mm-hmm.
I actually have a PhD student now. She listens to a lot of literature, and she listens with the voice of Snoop Dogg. And that works really well for her. She has some kind of service that makes everything sound like Snoop Dogg. So that's sort of the technology we are moving into. And Inger was talking about synthetic voices and the quality that previously wasn't good enough is starting to be good enough. So even you, because I have know you for many years, and even you now accept synthetic voices, and that's a big step for humankind. Or for technology, because I think that technology has improved.
Yes.
So one recommendation in the CELSE guidelines is to avoid synthetic voices. We did, or was, so, and we said that's not a good advice, because we need to accept that kind of voices in some situations. So it's the quality also of that kind of voices that is important, because they could equally be bad or good. And perhaps Snoop Dogg voices is always good. If you ask my PhD student, that's okay.
I will take it in English, yeah. Because I think there's more people left with this. Yeah, I'm studying this. I remember that we also tested some AI, which was not included originally, but there was also a big difference, but there was one that was really good, and actually most of us liked it. So we were a bit optimistic that with technology we can each adjust the pacing, because we all like different sort of pacing. And me myself, I'm not from Sweden originally, and if the language you're reading in is not your original language, you might prefer it a bit slower, or if it's an old text with old words, you might need a bit more time. So that's also something. So I think with the technology, that's there's good possibilities. And when the process, when it was too slow for me, I totally lost what it was about, because I need to remember the words, then build the sentence myself. Because the sentences were equally long everywhere, so I need to build the sentences myself. So I completely lost what the whole story was about, or what the whole sentences were about. So the pauses are really important for understanding the sentence and the structure of the text, and that is really important for the understanding of the text itself. And that it has to feel natural, so somehow. Then what is natural, I don't know. Thank you.
Jag har ju jobbat på Dyslexiförbundet och träffat hundratals barn och vuxna som läser talböcker. Och är man en ovan talboksläsare så blir man oftast irriterad på talsyntes och vissa röster. Men när man har lyssnat kanske i många timmar så blir man mera van. Så jag brukar skoja och säga att man kan måste se talsyntes som en dialekt. Man måste ställa om sina öron och acceptera den. Och det är också många barn som har nytta av talböcker, men inte vill ha talböcker för man tycker att det är konstigt och annorlunda. Så det här med att läsa talböcker, det handlar inte bara om rösten. Det handlar om att accepterande. Att jag behöver talböcker. Det går lättare för mig. Jag lär mig mer om jag har talböcker. Tack.
Inger is talking about this. Besides all the quality issues or matters, you also have to accept the specific technology and that you are a person who need that kind of support. Maybe there are questions from the audience, Esther.
Do we have any questions from the audience?
How long were the pauses between a sentence and the other? So we're talking about pauses after at the end of the sentence. So how long were the pauses?
How long were they?
We had like four different,
three or four
different ones with different amount of length of pauses. But what you said, if it's sent out, they will get the link.
Yeah, you can listen to the different. So they are online. So.
But they are in Swedish.
They are in Swedish.
It's Selma Lagerlöf.
Yeah.
We will send them out so we can listen after that. We were trying to, we thought we should say them after we are in 25.
Not another technical layer to this conference. But say between words, we had, let's say it was one second, 1 to 2 seconds, and that was far too long. So that was exceeding a limit where you lost the connection between the words.
Yeah.
But the pause with 2 seconds after a sentence is quite okay, or you can have more. So time is sort of regarded differently because where do you put the pause?
Mm. And when it's a new paragraph,
yeah,
longer.
Yeah, so you could actually work with that in the recording so that you have a specific amount of time is representing a pause between sentences and then a longer unit of the paragraphs. That would create a structure.
Yeah.
And as someone said, it makes it possible for me to think about what I am reading. So you sort of, it's a way of keeping up with the story. You need those pauses to be able to do that. I think that's what you said, Carlotta. The pauses is really important.
And for example, when you have a new chapter, maybe even longer pause, and then you read the name of the chapter or like chapter 5, or, and then you have another pause, and then you start reading, like longer pause, then, and when between words, you need just even a second. It could be small between words, but when the sentence phrases, you can longer pauses, especially when it's new chapter.
Words would be like normal speed.
Yeah. Normal speed.
Thank you very much for the presentation. It was really interesting to hear the feedback firsthand. My question is, in the ideal world, like we are getting more and more technology to intervene, right? And from what I'm feeling, there is a lot of individual variation of what people prepare. So in the ideal world, what would be the things you can pick and choose for yourself? From what I'm hearing, I would guess it's the speaker, it's the base. Is there something else that you would like to be able to address and to choose for yourself individually? Or is it mostly just the base and the speaker?
I would say also the pauses, because we regard enough pause differently. So if you could manipulate pauses in a different way, I think people would start to do that.
Yeah, I don't think it's possible yet, maybe in the future, but what we talked about, the emotion that is put into the text, and that is something I think is so very problematic to put into technology just right now. Anyway. But also, I just want to, because I also looked at my notes from the when we had to, even if there was differences in what we thought, I think we all agreed on which one was worst. And the top ones, there was like not a complete consensus, but there were two that were the top for all of us. So that there is a, even if there's personal preferences, there's still, you can still make guidelines that work for most people.
Hello, my name is Lambert, and I work for the Swedish Radio. And I have a question about accents or dialects. Did this include, or did you have?
In this case, we had the same narrator reading everything, so it wasn't an accent thing. So we didn't discuss accent that much, or did we? With the synthetic voices, we discussed. Yeah, then came a short discussion about different voices, and we touched on accents on that discussion, but it wasn't central in this testing.
What do you think about this? Yeah. If I ask the panel,
yeah.
What's your opinion?
Hjalmar, will you say anything?
I think it depends on if it accent is relevant. If it's for example, if it's described in a book that this is a person that came from, come from Finland or something, and it should feel more real that it's a Finnish accent, for example. But if it have nothing to do with the story, just put in there for some reason, then I think it's no point. So it depends on, but some people don't want to have any accent, so you should have that option if you don't like it.
I don't think about just the accent, the sound sentences. When people have voices, the sound very pitch is very. I don't like that. I don't know if it have something to do with the accent. That is what I think most about.
Yeah, that was with the S sound that we talked about earlier. That some people have some sounds that just cut through your ears almost. And with the accents or dialects, as I said, I'm not from Sweden. So in the beginning when I lived here, people from North Sweden, if they speak in their dialect, I don't understand them. But I think also that's what you said, that you also need to get used to it. And I wouldn't prefer that, oh, this person and this character comes from that, and then it's a different accent. I wouldn't like that at all. I want it the same, read the same way, kind of. That was my way.
So did you learn anything about choosing between dramatized and not dramatized? Is that also something that we would like the possibility to choose between?
I try to speak English. For me, it's important that not is dramatized. I don't like dramatized. Because, as I said before, if it's not dramatized, I see pictures in my head. I can, it just feel good to think, if they dramatized, they do it for me. And I will not do it, I will do it myself. But many especially youngsters when I speak to, they said, I want that dramatized. Some skådespelare. Accents. That is more, so that is if you are used to it or not. And I think you more talking books you read, you were more, you were used to have this non-dramatized. And if you are not used to it, you like have it more dramatized, is that I think.
But you can be an experienced listener and prefer more feeling. And I think you like that.
Mm, I liked when the actors.
Yes, okay. I know.
I prefer that. Or the author himself.
So we have the ends of two scales here.
I think I'm about some between.
Yeah, is between. And,
sometimes I like it, sometimes I don't like it.
Yeah.
It was one recording when they wrote it very slowly.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I didn't like it.
No.
May I?
Yes.
One more.
Take a little bit.
I'm not completely sure, but on the experiences I have with directors and on the people I know, I can make a match because I work in the accessibility with people that have own experiences. And the general thing that I can, if I can generalize, it's mostly the people with ADHD that needs more emotion and more faster pace and need more of that, so their focus and attention can stick. I myself can have good attention if my settings are good, but I don't want too much different input. But that's just what I observe. I have no concrete statistics for this.
And that's a general.
I think you're
question.
Right.
Yeah.
I have ADHD. And we like that. More things like a painting, more color, not so. I think that with the drama in the book also. Yes.
But if the impressions become too many, then I think you don't like it. So it's also on how to emphasize things. But
and it depends to when.
Yeah, when.
Sometimes if it should be anything,
yeah.
It must be right. In the,
yeah,
in this case.
I think that's also an important. If something is annoying, it can totally ruin the experience of it. So if it's wrong. Why is this happening? Then it sort of could be very, very harmful.
It's like if someone acting wrong, it's supposed to be happy and it sounds sad, or it should be supposed to be sad and sounds happy.
Yeah.
It's wrong. It's like that.
And a general conclusion is that we are on a scale, so it's not that you can sort of say this is exactly how to do this, because people have different opinions and they place themselves on a scale.
Mm-hmm.
So I think you should run up here. Do you have any more
questions?
I was wondering whether you have any visual preferences for male or female voices, and whether you like younger or older voices. Do you ever think about it?
Or the micken. I will go with
micken. Oh, you have no preference. It's more about the way they talk.
Yeah.
It's not male, female, or something. It's just the way they talk.
No. I agree with her.
I agree. Man or woman, young or old, it's the most important. Is how they speak.
Yeah, I agree too, but I also think that sometimes they could be like, it's not important, but it could be like fitting that if it's a male author, it could be male, right? Even if it's not the author who read it. And if it's a female author, it could be a female reading. But it's not important thing. It just like feels good, but it doesn't have to be like that.
Camilla, vad tycker du? Spelar det någon roll om det är en man eller kvinna?
Vi hör väl inte. Vi kan bara göra tummen upp.
Eller skriva på chatten.
Du får skriva i chatten.
Eller tummen upp, tummen ner.
Ja. Jag vill säga Camilla, what if that matter for her? Spelar någon roll för dig?
It depends on the dog. I don't know. Sometimes I prefer the male voice and sometimes prefer the female voice. It depends what kind of genre. And if it's for a younger audience, maybe a younger actor. So.
May I just make a comment here? I have some good friends in the United States, and they say that, you know, the GPS function where you can choose who is giving you direction. George Clooney is number one. So I guess it has something to do with what kind of information or what kind of text or what kind of information you're receiving. But apparently, it's easier to find your way using the GPS in the US in George Clooney in your direction.
And the current knowledge says that for PhD students, it's Snoop Dogg.
Okej. Man kan passa på att i framtiden att man kan göra egna
inställningar. Det kommer.
Okej.
So we should. Thank you for the time. I think you have done a tremendous
job. CELSI, spoken easy language for social inclusion. Partners are Zavod RISA, RTV Slovenija, Dysleksiförbundet, Università degli Studi di Pavia, Vieglas Valodas Agentura, Vilnius Universitetas, Vsi informatio scaupimo ir sklaidos centras. Funded by the European Union.